Good evening. Please join me here at the table. Don't mind Joseph. The poor thing's a mute.
I'm Erwin Tollwood. This is my wife, Maybelle.
Pleased to meet you. My name is Anna. I'm Madame Addison's assistant.
What is that for?
The Madame documents all of her sessions. Joseph there will be taking photographs, and the phonograph will record sound.
And why does she do that?
Curious things may happen here tonight.
Good evening.
Thank you for seeing us.
I will do my very best to help you. Yes. A skeptic.
I beg your pardon?
I must ask that you put your full faith in me during the session. Negativity and doubt can easily taint the connection.
I'll have faith if you help us find our daughter.
Erwin, please. Please, take your seats.
Did you bring what I asked for?
Yes. We just didn't understand why.
I need something that was personal and dear to her. It simply helps me to make contact. Personal items strengthen the spiritual bond.
I hope this will suffice. It's her favorite.
And your personal items? That will do just fine. She has her father's eyes.
Why did you ask us to come here so late tonight?
3 o'clock is the witching hour, my dear. The time of night when the barrier between the living and the dead is thinnest.
Are you trying to tell me that my daughter's already dead?
If we make direct contact with her, there is a good chance she has passed. How long ago did she vanish?
3 weeks.
Throughout the session, it is imperative that we do not break the circle. If we do indeed make contact with her, only one of us shall speak at a time. You must ask questions with a yes or no for an answer. One tap for no, and 2 taps for yes. Understood?
Yes.
Let us join hands. Foul spirits, be warned. Thou shalt be banished if ye approach this circle. We only wish to contact whom we ask. You have been warned by all that is good and pure. Please, open your eyes and place your fingertips on the table. Elena Tallwood. Dearest Elena, we call out to you. Are you present with us? Elena, we only wish to ask you a few questions. Would you like to join us?
Elena, sweetie, don't be afraid.
This is ridiculous.
No.
Elena, was that you, dear?
Elena, it's Mommy. Was that you on the piano? Yes.
Good job, Elena. This is a safe place. Please join us at this table.
Elena, are you okay?
No.
Erwin.
Elena, did someone hurt you?
Yes. Who hurt my baby?
Elena, did someone kill you?
This is another outrage.
Do not break the sacred circle.
Erwin, stop it.
She's a fraud, a complete fraud. The piano and the table are rigged.
Thank you. Pick one.
Not happening.
Come on, pick one.
I said no.
Please.
In 1,000 feet, turn right.
Will you shut up if I pick one?
Guys, please be quiet. I'm trying to hear the GPS. Victoria, pick a card.
Good. Now place it back in the deck. Your card has magically risen to the top. Is this your card?
No.
You are approaching.
You're lying.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
Hey, what the hell? Stop
it! Damn it, guys, I said knock it off. Thank you.
Your destination is on the right.
This is it.
Can we just pick a house already?
This is beautiful.
It looks like a giant dollhouse.
I can't believe you're making us move, so this is actually gonna happen.
I like it already. Let's take it.
Well, we haven't seen the inside yet. Who knows? It could be filled with 1,000 cats.
How many more do we have to look at?
As many as it takes till we find one.
Do you really think there are 1,000 cats in there?
No, Aiden, he was joking.
Heh. The ad did say 3 o'clock.
I don't think you could have even picked an older house to look at, Dad. Look, it's like a collapsed scene right there.
Well, with age comes character.
The sign does say open house. It smells like cookies in here.
This is nice.
Actually, not that bad. Green carpet's gotta go.
Guys, wait up! Hello?
Oh, hey, not your fault, little guy.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
Aiden, apologize to the lady.
I'm sorry, ma'am. I didn't see you there.
Please, call me Claire. Really, it's quite all right. I should have been waiting for you near the front door, but I was watching the cookies in the oven.
He can be a handful sometimes.
No worries. Please, continue looking at the house. I'll clean this up in no time. Really, it's okay.
Aiden, go find your sister.
Thank you.
Let me get this.
The house is old, but it was built to last.
Well, it's a bit more house than I was expecting.
I think it fits right into your price range.
How do you know my price range?
Well, I assume you read the ad.
Yeah. What's the catch?
The doorbell needs repair.
Seriously, a house this size for that price?
Cookie?
No, I'm trying to drop some.
Quite honestly, the city wants the house to sell before it wears. May I ask about your wife? Will she be joining us?
She recently passed. It still doesn't seem very real.
I'm so sorry for your loss. When did she...
3 months ago. It seems like just yesterday she was here, and now she's gone, so...
Well, God tests us in the toughest ways sometimes, doesn't he? That explains the move, then.
Yeah, I figured a fresh environment would be good for the kids, and...
Well, you made the right decision. The schools in this neighborhood, fantastic. I think this house will do well for your family.
I'll get that room. You wish.
Hey, right on time.
Just one, guys.
Maybe two.
What do you say?
Thanks.
You're welcome.
Hey! Easy with the stuff, guys. Jesus. Nope.
What the hell?
I told you I don't want to see you smoking.
I'm not a baby anymore, Dad. I can do whatever I want.
Honey, I only want what's best for you.
Then maybe moving me away from all of my friends right after my mom died wasn't such a good idea, huh?
Sweetheart, we're all in this together. I'm gonna need your support. I'm gonna need you to be a little bit more cooperative.
Please, just leave me alone.
Does this look like the kitchen?
I was just taking a break. Sheesh.
Isn't this great?
I love it.
I still don't understand why we had to leave the old house.
Well, we talked about this, hon. I think this move is gonna be the best thing for all of us. You'll get used to it.
It's kind of creepy.
Scaredy cat.
I'm not scared.
I think all it needs is a good cleaning and some fixing up. I'm gonna have this place looking tip-top in no time. How you feel about Chinese food for dinner?
Sure, I don't care.
Can we set up my room next?
One step at a time, little man. Tell you what, why don't you get up and help?
Nah, I'm fine.
Aiden, get up and help.
No, that's okay. I mean, at this rate, who knows how long it's gonna take to get to his room. Huh? Mr. Non-Helper?
No, I'll help, I'll help!
Give me the cards, I'll show you a trick.
Dad?
Yep.
Can we hang this up?
I think that's a good idea. Where should we put it?
Somewhere we can all see it every day.
How about...
above the couch?
That's perfect. Hold it for me, buddy. Come here.
Perfect.
What do you think?
Great.
Food's here.
That better be the food. I'm starving like Marvin.
You don't look like you're starving.
Izzy, food's here.
Hey, how much?
I think your doorbell's busted.
Yeah.
$32.50, please.
Okay, there's 40.
Thanks.
Keep the change.
When'd you guys move in?
Today, actually.
Didn't think anyone ever buy this house.
What do you mean by that?
Have a good night.
Enjoy.
This smells pretty good.
Can we get in here and watch TV? Please? Please?
Okay, but only tonight. Where are you going?
Pizza forks.
I think they're in a box on the kitchen table.
I can't wait to see how terrible the food is here.
We got chopsticks.
I'm sorry, hon, I was starving.
The light in the kitchen just blew out.
Now it begins.
Izzy, where are you going? Stay here and eat with us.
I'm good.
Yes, have an egg roll. They're amazing.
Those were Mom's favorite.
Buddy, did you have a nightmare again?
I heard something, Dad.
There's nothing in here, hon. I think you're just not used to this new room yet.
I saw someone. There's someone in here.
I don't see anybody. I think you're just tired from the move. I know we all are. Tell you what, I'm gonna leave that light on, and I'm gonna leave that door open. And if you need me, you just call for me, okay?
No, please.
Aiden, there's nothing in here, okay? Now let's tuck you back in.
There we go. Legs out.
Let's get the blanket on. Let's tuck you in real tight, like a burrito. I love you, buddy.
Make sure you count 50.
I will.
In Mississippi's.
One Mississippi, two Mississippi, three Mississippi, four Mississippi, five Mississippi. 13 Mississippi, 14 Mississippi, 15 Mississippi, 16 Mississippi, 17 Mississippi, 18 Mississippi. Good. Now I got you back for the other day.
This stuff is awesome.
It must have belonged to the people who used to live here.
Everything looks weird through this thing.
If you keep trying to scare me, then I'm gonna smack you.
I don't like it up here. I'm gonna take this stuff to Dad.
What you got there?
I found some cool stuff in the attic.
This whole entire house and you end up in the dusty old attic.
This entire house is dusty.
Wow. Ain't that something?
I knew you liked the pocket watch.
Victoria. Victoria.
I'm just playing, Daddy. Can I have that back, please?
Let me speak to Claire about some of this stuff.
But we bought the house. It's ours now.
I haven't seen you play with your dolls in a long time.
Well, Mommy bought them for me, and I missed them.
Okay, sweetie. Let me just check some of this stuff out, okay? Who knows, it could be worth a whole bunch of money. Thank you.
Hi, you've reached Claire at Primetime Realty. Please leave your name, number, and a brief message, and I will be happy to return your call.
Hey, Claire, this is John on Willow Road. When you get a chance, can you call me back on my cell? A few things about the house that I want to ask you. Thanks. Bye.
Holy shit.
Hey, watch your mouth. What were you guys doing in here?
Wasn't us, Dad.
We didn't do it.
Fucking A.
Enough with the swearing, goddammit.
Nothing I haven't heard before.
Seriously, what happened?
I don't know. Victoria, would you go get some bags out of the kitchen, please?
Okay.
Aiden, you go get the broom and the dustpan. Well, don't just stand there. Give me a hand.
Seriously, this is, like, freaking me out. Think the house is haunted?
No. Don't be ridiculous. There's got to be some practical explanation. I didn't screw the legs into the bookcase well enough.
Yeah, that makes a lot of sense.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Don't come in here, buddy. There's glass.
I got you.
Thanks, Aiden. You can go up to your room.
What?
Oh, nothing. No, you just reminded me of your mother just then. Morning.
I'm Melissa. I live next door.
I'm John. I'm the new homeowner.
I meant to stop by and welcome you guys to the neighborhood, but my father's been such a handful.
Is everything okay?
He has a lot going on right now. I'm watching after him.
Okay.
He had a stroke a while back and hasn't been the same since. Mix that with dementia, and well, let's just say he's a lot to handle.
That's terrible. I'm really sorry.
Yeah, I know. It's sad. It's hard. But I get through it. I saw your kids running around the other day. Cute little things. I'd love to meet your wife.
She recently passed. I'm still learning how to say that.
Oh, I am so sorry to hear that.
It's okay.
Please, if you ever need help with the kids, or if you just need some time alone, I'd be happy to watch them.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
Look at us. The first time we meet, we're exchanging sob stories. You know what? I'm gonna bake up a cake and bring it over to you guys.
Oh, no, that's not necessary.
I'm right next door if you need anything. I am just so happy this old house finally sold.
How long has this house been empty?
Well, I don't know if it's ever been empty.
What do you mean by that?
Oh, I've just seen some mice coming from it. You might want to keep an eye.
Yeah, I'm sorry about that. I'll check into it. Maybe I'll get a cat.
Oh, no need to apologize. It's not your fault. Anyway, I should get back to my father.
Nice meeting you. Aiden! Victoria! Time to get up! Jeez. I didn't expect you guys to be up. You're never up this early.
What's for breakfast?
I'm gonna make oatmeal.
Aiden, what do you feel like?
Eggs.
Eggs. You got it. Coming up. How do you like them, bud? Sunny or scrambled?
Scrambled.
You got it. Eggs are spoiled. I'm not. How about some cereal? Enjoy. Hold that, I'll be right back. Fix yourself some cereal. Hello?
Good morning, John. Oh, sorry, I went around to the back to see if you guys were home, rang the doorbell a few times.
Now, hello, Claire. Yes, the doorbell is still busted.
Well, you better get on that, Mr. Fix-It. Hey, I got your message this morning. I was in the neighborhood showing a property down the street. Figured I'd swing by.
Thank you. You didn't have to do that, but a phone call would have been good, but thank you.
No problem. What would you like to discuss about the house?
Well, my kids found this very old chest in the attic.
Yes. I believe I mentioned that the remains of the house were part of the purchase.
Yes, you did. It's the contents of the chest that's concerning me.
And what did you find?
Do you mind if I show you for a second?
I'm here. Might as well.
Sorry about that. I told my kids not to play with this stuff until I spoke with you.
curious little things, aren't they? Hello, again, dear.
Izzy!
I can see her hormones are peaking.
Yeah, she hasn't been the same since my wife passed away.
She'll come around. Death changes people. So, what's the problem?
Well, did you find these photographs peculiar? Makes me wonder about the people that lived here before us.
John, the house is over 100 years old. I have no information on the previous owners. You're welcome to check public records, if you like. As for the photos, they had various methods of altering these images. Spirit photography was very popular in the 1800s.
Spirit photography?
Yes. During the spiritualist movement, people had seances and such. Often photographers used various lighting tricks to create interesting photos to build up hype for their meetings.
How do you know all this?
I spend way too much time in the New Age section of the bookstore. Believe it or not, it fascinates me.
So you think these photos are staged?
Maybe. I don't know. Maybe.
Excuse me.
Victoria! Aiden! Victoria!
Is everything okay?
Jesus Christ. Oh my God. Baby! Baby! Aiden! What happened? What happened?
Oh my God! Baby. Do you want to get her inside?
I got you, baby. I got you. I got you, baby. I got you. Come here. Shh. Baby. Baby girl.
John, what can I do?
Claire, could you go to the kitchen and get us a glass of water?
Right away.
Are you okay, sweetie?
Yeah. I'm just a little dizzy.
All right, well, sit up. You want to sit up? You want to lay down?
Yeah.
Breathe.
Hey, buddy, you okay? You're gonna be fine. Why don't you scoot upstairs and change? Nobody needs to know.
Thank you. Thank you so much for your help.
I'm glad she's okay.
I'm gonna get her to a doctor.
I'm sure she'll be fine, but best to make sure everything's in order.
They really scare me.
They're lucky to have you.
Thanks.
If you need anything, feel free to reach out.
Thank you very much. How you feeling, baby girl?
I'm fine, honestly.
I thought I told you not to play with this stuff.
What? I like it. Can I keep it, please?
Okay, but only if we can get you to a doctor first.
No, I feel fine.
No excuses. We're going.
I probably just had low blood sugar. It happens to people all the time. I searched it.
We're going. Get dressed.
Get out of my room.
You're never around when I need you. Your sister just passed out in the backyard and you couldn't care less.
She did?
Yes. I'm taking her and Aiden to the doctor, and I need you to start caring more and start trying more and be present.
I can't believe you moved into the Addams Family house.
Oh, really? Shut up.
Or can we,
Hey, Gary.
What the hell?
What?
I thought you said your family left.
They did.
Mm-mm. Wait, I saw someone.
Oh my God.
Just hold on.
Dude, what?
I just saw someone, I swear.
There is nothing. Come on, they're not here. Hello? Yeah, just the usual is fine. Okay, you have to go
no,
right
no,
now.
No,
I swear. They're on their way.
No, we'll be really quick.
No, I don't have really quick.
I just need a minute, seriously.
No minutes, come on. They're really close. Where's your jacket?
Shit. Seriously?
Yes.
Seriously?
Yes, get out! Come on. Later. Okay. Go. Hurry. What'd the doctor say?
He said he thinks it was low blood sugar. He said if it happens again, we can take her in and get an MRI and some blood work.
No one's getting my blood.
All right. A burger with growth. I should probably get my lazy butt upstairs and start cleaning out that attic. Can you keep an eye on them while I'm up there?
Yeah, I think I can do that. Hey. I'm glad you're feeling better, Vic.
Okay.
Thank you.
hell is that now? That's the end of him. Who are you?
Elena. Elena Tollwood.
What are you doing up here? Why are you in my house? Why are you in my house? Do your parents know you're here?
It's too late.
It's too late for what, hon?
Burn them.
Burn what?
Burn them. She's coming!
Madam Addison's House of Spiritualism was a well-known place for social seances. During the mid-1800s, she held countless numbers of seances and rituals for those who sought to contact the dead. In late October of 1891, Madam Addison was found strangled to death in her home. Four other people were also found dead. No one truly knows what happened, but many believe it was the outcome of a seance gone horribly wrong. Give me the doll and the camera.
But Dad...
I said no.
This doll reminds me of Mom.
Honey, this stuff, it's not good. Give it to me.
This is bullshit.
Aiden, go to your room.
Dad.
What?
Why are you doing that?
Because it's garbage, that's why.
But I like that stuff. It gives the house character.
Well, I've had it up to here with this house and its character. It's gone.
Can I please just have the doll?
Absolutely not.
Mom would have let me have it.
Well, your mom is gone, isn't she?
Does that sound crazy, Mom?
When your father passed, I thought I saw him around the house a few times.
I keep having these hallucinations.
Are you taking your antidepressants?
Yes, of course.
Okay. Did you look into the history of the house?
Apparently there was a murder and the woman who owned it ran some type of church out of it.
There's your answer. The realtor didn't mention any of that when you asked?
Nope.
She's required by law to mention that kind of stuff.
Yeah, I really had to dig around to find out anything about this house.
The best thing to do is ignore any type of occurrences. Don't feed into the negative energy. I used to burn sage in our house once a month just to cleanse the negative currents. I'm gonna book a flight out there for next week.
No. That's too much. It's not necessary. I appreciate it, though.
I'm coming either way. If the house doesn't feel right, we'll put it right back up on the market.
I can afford that, not for a while at least.
I'll put you guys up in a hotel if I have to, or you can move in with me. When do you start back up with work?
Next week, doing a remodel in the local business, and the kids start school too.
Don't worry, I'll be there soon. I love you.
I love you too.
I'll check in with you before I fly out. I knew I should have stayed up there after the funeral.
You guys want to go see a movie? Answer me when I'm talking to you.
I'm going out. I'll talk to you later.
You guys want to play a board game? That could be fun. You can pick. No?
Not really. You may be excused.
Come on. guess it's just you and me, bud.
Are we gonna eat takeout for dinner every night?
So, I need to get some stuff from the store. Put your shoes on. We're gonna take a ride.
No, I don't want to. We're watching a movie.
Then you can put it on pause. We'll finish it when we get back.
Come on, Dad. I'll watch it and you go.
Absolutely not.
Why do you keep treating me like a baby?
I know you're not a baby anymore, and I'm very proud of you. Perfect timing. I need to get some stuff from the store. Can you keep an eye on these two?
Okay.
Thank you. Hey, Claire.
Hi.
What's up?
Hello.
Yes.
John, how are you?
I'm good. Is everything okay?
Yes, everything's fine. I just wanted to check in and see how Victoria was doing.
Oh, yeah, she's fine. The doctor said it was nothing serious, so thank you.
Oh, good. I'm glad to hear that. No problem.
Hey, while I have you, are you sure you didn't know anything about the history of the house? Well, I find that a little hard to believe.
And why would I lie to you, John?
Well, I can think of a few reasons. Commission, number one, and... Hello? Claire? Claire?
I'm home. Hello, guys? Guys? Hello? Aiden? Victoria? Victoria?
Three of Swords. It relates to heartache and sadness.
What the hell is going on in here?
I'm sorry.
Please leave.
Dad!
No, I apologize. I rang the bell and...
I told you kids not to play with this stuff. You scared the hell out of me.
But...
You know, it's my fault. I came by to bring that cake that I baked.
Oh, well, I appreciate the fucking cake. I don't appreciate you teaching them about this shit, and I don't appreciate you entering my house when I'm not here.
Well, they told me that you left them alone. How was I supposed to just leave them alone?
Are you calling me a bad father? I left him in charge with my older daughter. Thank you. Please get out of my house. Now!
I'm sorry, guys.
What the hell is wrong with you?
She had a cake. I know who she was. I saw you talking to her the other day.
Don't talk back to me! I left you in charge of your little brother, and you let strangers into the house?
I wish you were gone and Mom was still here. Stop screaming!
Izzy! Izzy, open the goddamn door! Izzy, open the goddamn door! Izzy, open the goddamn door!
Grounded.
What? Are you kidding me? Oh my gosh.
Get out of my house. Leave my family alone!
I'm so sorry.
Melissa.
I just had to come back and apologize. I intruded on your family. It was wrong.
I know you meant no harm. I apologize for yelling.
You had every right to. It's just...
What?
There's something not right about this house. My father came to lay mousetraps when it was vacant. Something happened to him. He had a stroke, and he hasn't been the same ever since.
Melissa, I'm truly sorry about your father. I appreciate you coming by, but it's late, so I gotta...
Is everything okay, John?
Everything is fine. Good night.
Hey, babe.
Hey. What's the plan?
Just thought we'd go park somewhere. Spend some time together.
Real smooth.
So when are you gonna tell your dad about us?
Not anytime soon. At least that is if you never want to see me again.
Is that serious?
Just believe me when I tell you it's not a good idea, okay?
Well, I have some good ideas.
What are those?
Thank you.
Stay put, I'm coming. I got you. I got you. Victoria? Guys? I'm here. Where are you guys? Answer me, guys. You gotta help me out. Aiden? Victoria? No, stop! Wait!
Dad? Victoria? Victoria? Dad, you up here? Oh my God! Dad! What happened?
Burn it.
What are you talking about?
Burn it.
What are you talking about?
Burn your chest.
No. No.
Thank you.
You okay? Oh my God. Wake up, baby.
What happened?
Oh my God. I love you guys so much. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. Are you guys okay? Wake up, baby. Wake up, wake up. Are you okay? Wake up, Aiden. Hi, can I please have an ambulance and police? I'm at 329 Willow.
The number you have reached has been disconnected.
Hello? Hello? This is gorgeous.
Yes, this is it.
Look at that porch. It's amazing.
Three o'clock, right on time.
Again with earthly things.